Saturn launch vehicle film report number 37 covers progress of the Saturn 1B and Saturn V programs during the period July, August, and September 1968. The fifth Saturn 1B flight vehicle, scheduled to launch the first manned Apollo spacecraft in mid-October, neared completion of its various pre-launch preparations and checkout operations as this quarter closed. At Launch Complex 34 of the Kennedy Space Center, mating of the launch vehicle, designated SA-205, and its Apollo 7 spacecraft had been completed on August 30th. Launch vehicle flight software was also delivered from the Marshall Space Flight Center to KSC during August. In early September, the pre-flight review was concluded, with no significant vehicle problems revealed. Then came the week-long countdown demonstration test, simulating the actual countdown for the 205 launch up to the moment of ignition. The flight readiness test was performed in late September. The flight readiness review, the final major pre-launch event, was then successfully completed, confirming the vehicle's readiness for flight. The Apollo 7 flight will carry astronauts Walter Schirra, Don Eiseley, and Walter Cunningham into a 120 by 150 nautical mile Earth orbit in a test of the spacecraft systems lasting up to 10 days. Saturn 1B launch vehicles have performed flawlessly in four previous unmanned missions. At the Marshall Center, S-1B-12 underwent successful acceptance static firings, both short and long duration, during July. This booster is the last of the stages authorized in Marshall's first order of S-1B stages with the Chrysler Corporation. After post-static inspection, the stage was shipped in early August from MSFC to the assembly facility in New Orleans for post-static modification and storage. At Michoud, fabrication work continued on subsystems for the follow-on contract, S-1B stages 13 and 14. Tentative plans for production of two additional stages for Apollo applications program requirements have been dropped due to budgetary limitations. In September, NASA announced termination of production of H-1 engines under contract with the Rocketdyne Division of North American Rockwell Corporation at Canoga Park, California. Of the 60 engines being produced, Rocketdyne has completed delivery on 32 to the Marshall Center. In August, S-1B-8 became the first 1B stage to be locked into one of Michoud's new long-term storage enclosures for hard storage. Tests were begun at Michoud this quarter on the first components scheduled to be requalified under Chrysler's quality maintenance program. Many of these components were qualified in the early part of the S-1B program and are now being retested to ensure that the current quality and reliability are equivalent to that of the components as originally tested. A new long-term storage enclosure for Saturn 1B second or S-4B stages underwent testing at the Huntington Beach facility of the McDonnell Douglas Corporation, S-4B prime contractor. The enclosure is furnished with all accessories necessary to maintain the required environmental conditions, such as temperature, humidity, dew point, and absence of contaminants for extended storage periods. The instrument unit for the seventh Saturn 1B flight vehicle was brought out of short-term storage and entered the retrofit cycle in July at IBM's Huntsville facility. Other IUs for Saturn 1B remained in storage. Also during this quarter, the three Earth-orbiting Pegasus meteoroid technology satellites, which were conceived by MSFC and launched by the Saturn 1 in 1965, were silenced by NASA after having successfully performed their missions and outlived their planned lifetimes. At KSC's Launch Complex 39, re-erection of the third Saturn V flight vehicle, AS-503, was accomplished early this quarter in the vehicle assembly building following completion of additional second stage testing and instrument unit modification. These had been required when the AS-503 flight was changed by NASA from an unmanned to a manned mission. AS-503 will orbit the Apollo 8 spacecraft carrying astronauts Frank Borman, James Lovell, and William Anders. checkout of the AS-503, which is scheduled for launch in December, was proceeding satisfactorily at the end of the report period. Rollout to the pad was expected October 10th. Saturn launch complex computer tapes and launch vehicle digital computer tapes were delivered to KSC by the Marshall Center, and update inputs were continuing as necessary. Acceptance testing of the Apollo Command Module Access Arm was also performed at Marshall prior to shipment of the arm to KSC for installation on the mobile launcher. During the flight of the second Saturn V launch vehicle, AS-502, last quarter, two major technical problems, the so-called pogo effect and ruptured ASI lines, had developed. Under direction of the Saturn V program manager, Lee B. James, NASA and contractor engineers concentrated on solutions to those problems during much of this report period. The solution to the pogo problem, excessive longitudinal oscillations originating in the S1C stage, will be the use of accumulators, or small helium gas reservoirs, in the liquid oxygen pre-valves feeding the stages 5 F1 engines to change the frequency of oscillations in the propulsion system. Each pre-valve, located in the LOX duct just above the engine, has a cavity in which a gas pocket will be maintained to serve as a shock absorber. The only modification required is a means of injecting the helium into the pre-valve. This pulsar mechanism was used for measuring the frequency of the propulsive system in extensive testing to prove out the corrective action. In F1 static firings, both at MSFC and at the Edwards test site in California, use of the accumulator method proved effective in damping oscillations occurring in the LOX feed ducts. This reduced the natural frequency of the propulsive system from 4 to 2 cycles per second, as compared to about 4 for the vehicle structure. A total of only 2.1 cubic feet of helium is needed to accomplish the fix. The helium will be fed initially from a ground source. After launch, the small amount needed for replenishing will come from onboard helium vessels. Engineering analysis of test data revealed that the fix was completely effective. At the Mississippi test facility, a successful static firing in early August of the S1C stage for the 6th Saturn V flight vehicle, incorporating the necessary fix modifications, demonstrated the effectiveness of the method. The fix has already been applied to AS-503, and all other first stage engines are currently being modified. The other major AS-502 problem, a break in the fuel line to the J2 engine's augmented spark igniter, was also resolved this quarter, with replacement of the former flexible line with a redesigned rigid ASI line. The new ASI line assemblies are being installed by Rocketdyne in S2 stages at MTF and the Seal Beach, California facility of North American Rockwell Space Division, as well as in S4B stages at McDonnell Douglas's Huntington Beach facility and Sacramento test site. The ASI fix had been subjected to extensive J2 engine testing at Santa Susana, MSFC, and the Arnold Test Center in Tullahoma, Tennessee. In this Santa Susana firing, ASI assembly operating characteristics were verified by low-pressure tests at ignition and high-pressure tests at engine mainstage operating conditions. S2 battleship stage firings to provide cluster engine data on the redesigned ASI assembly were also successfully performed at Santa Susana. The final test was accomplished at the Mississippi test facility during the acceptance firing of S-25, which had been modified to include the new fuel lines. All AS-502 problems have now been resolved. Meanwhile, by the end of September, all elements of the 4th Saturn V flight vehicle, AS-504, had been delivered to KSC, and erection of the vehicle is expected at the beginning of next quarter. At the Michoud assembly facility, the Boeing company continued assembly operations on S1C stages 10 through 12 and sub-assembly work on stages 13 through 15. Follow-on procurement for S1C stages, as well as other Saturn V vehicle stages, has not been approved by NASA headquarters. In the three-part S2 stage lightweight structural test program, testing of the A structure at the Marshall Center is nearing completion. All tests to date have been successful. Testing of the A structure is expected to be finished next quarter. At Santa Susana, tests using the B structure are scheduled to be resumed by North American Rockwell in October. Most test preparations, including installation of the forward skirt, were completed in September. Assessment of data on a failure of the C structure in its final test in late August is continuing at the Marshall Center. Failure occurred at 122% load condition of the 130% test goal. However, due to the already long life of the test item, it is contemplated that no further C tests will be performed. In July, the structure for Saturn V instrument unit number 9 was reassigned for a dynamic test program for the Manned Spacecraft Center and designated SIU-500S4. After instrumentation, the unit was moved from the IBM Huntsville facility to Wiley Laboratory Huntsville for testing, while mated to the S4B stage and spacecraft lunar module adapter. Tests got underway in September and will continue next quarter. MSFC's Saturn Program Office contributed significantly during the quarter to a NASA-wide launch vehicle working group study to examine NASA's present and future needs for launch vehicles, delineate various alternatives to meet these needs, and investigate practical means to reduce the cost of launch vehicles. In summation, as the historic first manned missions loomed closer for both the Saturn 1B and the Saturn V launch vehicles, painstaking preparation was NASA's watchword for the period July, August, September 1968.